Hey, dude, what's going on? It's Chris here. I'm happy to be back with you all. And I took about 2 days off from my sister's wedding, and I didn't look at any charts or prices or anything like that. Guys, I came back here, and it's not too exciting. But I just wanted to bring this to you on the 1 day chart, show you what I was seeing at least, talk about the indicators a little bit, and just kind of get back with you all. So, guys, first of all, we're going to start up here, and this is the chart that I had up when I left. So this is exactly how it was, and I just want to go through kind of what happened. So guys, right now what we're dealing with is we actually closed up above the 618, the 139 yesterday, and then we had another sell-off again, guys. So we weren't able to hold that and turn that 618 into support like I wanted to. So right now you can see that we've been having a little bit of a sell-off, and what we need to watch is to see if it breaks down through this wick here of yesterday around 132.45. We don't want to see it go any lower than that. So that's going to be a really big deal because, guys, what we need to start having are these higher lows and then higher highs. Like we talked about how we wanted to get up above this 153 again to set a higher high. You can see how we had a higher high, and then we had this actually lower low here, and now we needed to have a higher high, which we didn't get. So we need a lower low now, or a higher low, I'm sorry. So guys, volume's been really low as well. You can see right here, I'll draw a little trend line for you. So look at the volume, how that's really been tapering off right there. So we don't have the volume like I always talk about. Remember, we need moves accompanied by volume. That's going to be a really big deal. So our volume's been decreasing. Our stock RSI is at 20 and 15, so we're still very oversold. And this green line that I have down here, this was the bottom before we made runs. So I want to show you that. So see this bottom here, and then we had a really big run up to the top where we went up to around 96, 97 right there. Then we came back down. We didn't hit the bottom here, but we came back up. We hit the bottom here. We went up a little bit, and now we're kind of flirting around with this bottom again. So it's a really big deal. We don't break below that. We need to hold that as support, but we need more volume to continue to make a move because each time back here, whenever we'd hit that, we'd make a little move, we'd make a little run. So we really need to do that. We've just been kind of having that sideways movement right now. So nothing special about that. Let's see on the RSI. The RSI here, this is the 40 line, which I said is really important. We don't want to get trapped under that, kind of be stuck. You know, we've been in this. I don't even know what to call it right now. Like, it's been a bear market, but overall, we're still in a bull market because we've been holding our overall upper trend line. But obviously, you can see from the sell-off when we talked about this double top or these tweezer tops, 184. We sold off from 184 all the way down to 128. That is a massive sell-off, guys. So now what we're trying to do is get those higher highs and higher lows back established so we could have a change in the trend and in the shift, which we really need to do. So right here, we've been above the 40. You see, we hit it here, we hit it here, we went up again, and it almost looks like we're coming back down to test it again. So I don't know if on the RSI that's going to be a triple bottom and then we're going to move, but we've been trapped between this 40 and this 48 right here, as you can see. So we need to get up above that 48 and turn that into support. So that's a really big deal as well. And then let's take a look at the MACD, see what that's looking like. And I hope you guys have been having a great day. I've just been really busy, so I haven't been able to get this for you. I got back home. I needed to mow and train my clients and all types of stuff. So I apologize. I haven't been able to get a video out. But you can see right here, guys, we've been underneath now. We've been negative since May 9th. So we've been underneath. But what we are having a little bit of, there's been a slight bullish divergence here. We really need to pay attention to that. Do you see the histogram? How we have been trying to move to the bullish side. So we don't want to continue to have these longer ones break out of that trend line I just drew. We want them to get smaller so that we can flip over to the positive. So that's a really big deal as well. And we need a nice hook to cross here. But guys, right now it's just we're at the mercy of the market. You know, I wish there was something I could tell you, but there's nothing right now. We just have to be patient. And this is with all coins. I mean, nothing's doing phenomenal right now. I just looked at CoinMarketCap, and I mean, it's red and green back and forth, but there's no big gains right now, anything like that. So It's just what we have to deal with. And let's check the Bollinger Bands quick. And you guys know how quick all this can change. Someone could come in, dump a few billion dollars in and get this market moving. But I was really hoping for a bounce from the consensus. But I also told you guys just to be careful because each year that has happened. And I feel like these big guys are getting smarter and smarter. And because people were anticipating that, they didn't allow it to happen. And there was that sell-off. So we're just at the mercy, guys. We're at the mercy of the big guys, the whales, and what we need to do is just ride their coattails and deal with it. So on the Bollinger Bands, right here, we're kind of in the middle. So this middle band up here has been acting as resistance, and we have not yet hit this lower part. Because typically, guys, when you hit this lower band, you see there's a little bit of a run. We hit the lower band, and then we ran up, we tested that middle band, and we failed, and now we came back again. And we've just been moving sideways. So not much to talk about here today, guys. I just more so wanted to come talk to you, talk about this volume, how low this volume's been. We need to have more volume. Got to get this sentiment back, but just hang in there, guys. You know, especially if you're a hodler, this is what's going to happen, you know. You're going to have to go through these times when the market's bad, and I just want you to be able to take advantage of when the runs do happen. Like the next run, most likely we're going to come up here and we're going to test these tweezer tops here at around 184, 185, and if we fail at that again, guys, we're most likely going to have another fall down. What we need to do is turn that into support. We need to get up above it, come back down, test it, hold it as support, and then make another move. But it just is what it is right now. So y'all be careful, be safe out there. I hope to bring you another video on something if I find some news or if anything happens, but there's just not a ton to talk about right now. So God bless each and every one of you, and just stay strong, my hodlers. Take care, and don't forget to like and subscribe.